Hey there, my name is Nick, and welcome to another video covering the many developer tools on WordPress.com. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to access your site's MySQL database using phpMyAdmin. I will also perform some actions on the database, and then I'll show you how to download a copy. So let's dive in. All right, so here we are on the site dashboard for a fictitious blog called Push to Prod. Now, the most important thing to note here is that we are on the business plan. Everything I show you in this video is going to be reserved for the business or commerce plans on WordPress.com. So to access the database for your site, what you're going to do is you're going to go over to the Settings tab, and then we're going to click on Database. Here you're going to have some information about phpMyAdmin. This is the tool, it's an open source tool that allows you to administer your MySQL database on WordPress.com. Now, a couple of quick things to note. On WordPress.com, every site on a business or commerce plan has a pre-configured database, and you only can have one database per site, and you can only use the one that's given to you. You cannot connect your site to an external database. So those are some limitations to be aware of. But what we're going to do to access the database is we're going to use this button here to access phpMyAdmin in a new window. So when we access it, it's going to provide a whole bunch of information. If this is your first time visiting phpMyAdmin, do not worry if you're a little overwhelmed. There's a lot of documentation and additional information that you can access right here on the side. And then on the left, we see all the different tables that are available in our database. Now, I'm not going to go through them all or all the functionality of phpMyAdmin, but I do want to take a quick look at the post table. So in WordPress, there's a lot of things, content that are of the post type variety, whether that's a post, a page, all sorts of things. And we can see that in this table here. We have navigation and headers and that sort of thing. But what we want to do is let's use this inline edit to modify the query. So we're going to do something really simple. You can get much more fancy and complicated with this. What we're going to do is we're going to type in where post types equal post. And this is going to simplify the view and just show us the three posts that are on this demo site. So next, what I want to do is I want to show you how to make just a quick edit. So let's click on one of these posts. And what we want to do is we want to modify the title of the post. So we'll scroll down here. We can see all the post content, all the block markup. If we keep scrolling, we'll get to the field where we can modify the title. So let's modify that here. And then let's scroll down further and we'll modify the slug for the post. So it's the same. Keep scrolling to the bottom, and then you have a couple options. In our case, we just want to save the content, so we'll keep it on save, and we'll click go. So the database will update, and you can see here that the post title has been updated as well. So let's head on over to the site to see if the changes are in fact there. So we'll go back to our dashboard, and we'll click on phpMyAdmin. Then we'll come over to our posts, and you'll notice here that the title has actually not been updated. So the reason for this is that WordPress.com employs server-side caching. This makes sure that your site is as performant as possible. But in our case here, we actually want to clear the cache so that we can see the changes that we made directly to our database. So it's very easy to do. Let's head back over to the site's overview. And instead of clicking on that database tab, we'll come down to performance. And there's a button that allows you to clear all caches. So we'll just click that. The caches have been cleared. Now let's go back to our post page and we'll click refresh. Now this might take a few seconds because all that content that was previously cached needs to be reloaded. But here we go. Now the title has been updated like we set in the database. So now the next thing I want to show you how to do is how to export a copy of your database. There's a couple ways to do this, but let's head back over to the overview tab and we'll scroll down to the bottom and we can see that there's a link for see all backups. So we're going to download the copy from one of our site backups. So we'll click on see all backups. This will take us back to phpMyAdmin and we'll be underneath Jetpack and then VaultPress. So VaultPress is where all your backups for your site are stored. Now you can pick any backup you want to download your site, your database copy, but I'm going to click on yesterday. And then there's a couple ways you can access the download. So you can click on the down arrow here and click on download backup. This will give you all the options of what to include in your backup. For the case of this video, we're going to uncheck everything and we'll stick to site database. Now, before I click create, let's go back and I just want to show you a different way of doing it. There's also this actions button down here. Same thing, click on download backup. And let's just go to yesterday and we'll download the backup of our site database. So we'll uncheck everything, keep site database checked, and click create downloadable file. Now, depending on the size of your site, this may take a little bit. This is a demo site with very little content, so it's very quick. And then I can click download file. You'll also get an email that allows you to, with a one click, to download the file as well. All right, so you now know how to access your site's database using phpMyAdmin, make a few changes, and then also clear the server-side cache so the changes are reflected on your website immediately. Now, one more note before I go, modifying the database is an advanced task, and if you're ever uncertain about making a change, please reach out to support and our happiness engineers. They can provide you with further guidance. So I hope you found this video useful, and if you did and you're watching on YouTube, we'd love it if you'd like and subscribe, and also stay tuned for more developer-oriented content. Finally, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Have a great day.